Good morning, I am Agostino Bruzzone, professor in Genoa University and president of simulation team. I'm very glad to present you strategic engineering. Strategic engineering is a new discipline that has been introduced around 4 years ago in Boston, Cambridge, Massachusetts, by MIT, and it was created to support strategic decision making. Strategic engineering lays on three main pillars strongly integrated. There are simulation, data analytics, and artificial intelligence. As you can see from this slide, it's evident that major industry, consulting firm, international and national organization, as well as small medium-sized enterprise, are very interested. We have among our patron companies such as Hitachi, Leonardo is a major defense contractor in Italy, Thales is a major contractor from France in defense, and among the biggest one both worldwide. We have companies such as Accenture, we have a company in consultancy also as Arena, Ansaldo Energy and Power, Axpo, and so many one. People that work with satellite, people that work with business, and so on. The idea is to use in combined way this technology and to prepare young people, and in fact Genoa University is promoting this international Master of Science, 2 year duration to prepare young engineers and scientists in this area, but even to upgrade senior manager, executive, and officers in learning about this technology and this science, and to use that in improving decision making. Strategic engineering is something that is inspired to the concept of strategos. Now, strategos probably most of you knows, and this sentence in Greek that now we translate in English came from Socrates, is the definition of what is a strategos. In ancient Greek cities, the strategos was the general or the admiral that was commanding the force. And Socrates was used to say that the strategos has some kind of a gift, some kind of an art in understanding a little bit better what is happening and what will happen in future. Now, strategic engineering deals with that, to create models, tools, solutions that help us to understand what is happening in a better way and what will happen. And the synergy between simulation, data analytics, artificial intelligence is based on such concept. Now, these techniques are pretty new, are pretty popular now, but if we think about, they date many years ago. Let's talk about artificial intelligence. Most of you probably have seen the movies on Turing that was during the Second World War developing artificial intelligence solution for decryption of message. At that time, it was using analog computers. Not yet, digital computer was not yet existing. And if we think about simulation, John McLeod, one of the father of simulation, was working in the 50s and even late 40s with NASA, with Air Force, with US Navy to develop models running on analog computer to support analysis of rocket, of supersonic jet that after the war was a huge and very critical project. If we talk about data analytics, I would like to remind that the most simple algorithm, the average, the moving average, was developed by Romans over 2,000 years ago to decide how much wine had to import from Spain to Italy, from Greece, around, and still in use. So these techniques are innovative, but they date many years ago, at least more than half a century. But in strategic engineering, we use a little bit differently. Why? Because we use in closed loop. We have many more data now. We can collect this data from our smartphone. We can collect this data from digitalized company, from factory, from sensor. These data are creating big data that often are inconsistent. But using data analytics, artificial intelligence, we can filter and extract information. This information goes in the model that could allow us to understand what will happen, but it's not finished. The loop is closed. So based on this decision, that we take, we'll see if the real system reacts as expected by the model or in a different way. And in case, we recollect the data and we correct the model. So it means it's like to have a yacht that we sail and we correct regulation of sail, the rudder, expecting some performance. But when we realize that it's not achieved, we change a lot, a little bit everything, and we recorrect. And this strategic engineering approach allows us to take decision in this way, in a closer loop with the reality. Strategic engineering has this mission, so support decision maker. We don't create strategos. Strategos are people that have experience, that to take the decision based on many criteria, but we create solution and we prepare people to work side by side with the decision makers. In this way, they could get benefit of the new technology and improve their skills with knowledge come from the field. Update in real time, or at least real time, practically, because if we collect data from a ship to improve the asset to reduce consumption, even if arrive after 1 minute, it's pretty good. Depending on the problem, real-time constraints obviously are pretty different. And in our case, it's very important to outline that these techniques are combined with new enabling technologies such as IoT, sensor, etc., but even are very multidisciplinary, because we need to prepare people able to talk with decision makers, not just programmers. And this is the reason why even high officer, senior manager, executive could benefit to be involved in this one, because they will be necessary to be familiar with this approach, will be able to interact with the people that develop this solution and to take decision. So I will use some quote in order to highlight these points, and one came from Sun Tzu. You know that Sun Tzu is one of the major experts of strategy, the father maybe, dating back 2500 years, and even he addressed the point that the general who wins a battle makes a lot of computation, while the general that loses the battle makes few computations. Now, at that time, probably in ancient China, a lot of computation were dealing with Chinese abacus, with the capability to understand what are the parameters, to understand if you can win the battle and to win the battle before to fight it. But today, obviously, this kind of computation deal with model, algorithm, simulation, artificial intelligence system that support you in taking right decision and give you a strategic advantage. Now, the point is, I already used the example of smartphone. We had a system available for traffic control in the 80s, in the 90s, we had the control room in New York City, Rome, Tokyo, that was dealing with analyzing the urban traffic. That was costing $1 million. They use a lot of camera, a lot of device and sensor to collect the traffic, but was not so very useful for people to define the path to take. And even the town they use just mostly during the crisis. Today, thanks to this smartphone, we have systems that collect many more data, order of magnitude. They have a smart algorithm that filters this data and make it available. And now what happened? If I give you a direction to suggest you to take an alternative way with a big screen from a control room that cost $20 million, but just say you, there is a traffic jam. For me, traffic jam doesn't mean too much. I don't know how long it takes. Or if you say me, take this alternative path. I take the alternative path and I get jammed. Or I don't respect the suggestion. I go straight and everything is fine. I lose trustness of this system. So I don't take decision. But if I look at some system simple like a Google roadmap, and I realize day by day that the error is just 100 meters on the length of the queue. So it's very precise, very reliable. This gives me a direction, this gives me an help to take decision, because decision should be taken based on reliable information. If I don't have it, I can drive any case. But this is a strategic advantage I want to have, and in competition, I want to have this one. Let's move forward. Let's consider strategy definition itself. Usually, it's common to talk about strategy, but sometimes there is some misunderstanding. Often people use strategy to describe planning. We need a strategy, but they mean in reality we do a planning. Now, strategy requires planning, but it's not planning. Strategy is doing and succeeding. Now, a very good definition of strategy came from General Jomini, that as probably most of you know, is the theoretical, the theoretical general of Napoleon, was a Swiss general, not too much famous for leading army in the battle, but to write about how to manage battle, wars, and campaign. He was saying, very synthetic way, very good, give a very good definition of strategy, that is, la stratégie, c'est l'art de bien diriger. That means the strategy is the art to well direct. Because strategy is to identify a goal and to achieve it. Obviously, planning is very important. I like to outline even von Moltke. Von Moltke is a very famous Prussian army general that was saying, and is used often even out of the military sector, he was saying that there is no plan able to survive to the encounter with the enemy. Now, this is true for many reasons. It's true not only because the situation evolves, things change, unexpected events happen. And this obviously is true everywhere. But even because often our planning have to deal with opponent. In business is a competitor, in geopolitics could be somebody that have different interests. At work could be with a foe. This person, based on how we put in place the planning, will act a countermeasure, will react, will take their own decision. So what it means? That our plan will be very quickly updated, very quickly obsolete. But this doesn't mean we don't have to plan. It means that we need to plan dynamically, to be able to change dynamically the planning and to be able to react. And this point is very important. Strategic engineering deals with giving capability to make dynamic, continuous planning, but even control of the direction of the action to achieve the result. I would like to mention among the different quotes, even this one that is much younger from Mayun. Mayun was the former Alibaba executive director, that is, the Alibaba is the Chinese big, let's say, small brother of Amazon, but very, very quickly growing, maybe soon equal. And he said, if you want to make a big business today, you need to solve a social problem. So let me talk a little bit about some other interesting quote that I would like to mention. This is from Cristoforo Columbus. You know, I'm from Genoa University, and Cristoforo Columbus is supposed to be born in our town, and he's the person that discovered the Americas over 500 years ago. And he was saying that a strategos, a leader, should look at goal as tool to focus his energy and to be ready to change goal, to drop someone, to introduce new one, to achieve the final goal, the final target, final objective. Now, this is very important, I feel, in strategic engineering and for leaders, because often, you know, today we have such kind of gap. The leader get very short-term objective and don't get the whole picture and don't perceive the real goal. And we needed to create tool, instrument that can collect information from the field and help us to understand how to achieve the whole goal. And even to have young scientists work side by side with manager, helping them to lead their course, or to their direction, to obtain the final goal that we need to carry it out. Let me take another quote among this one that is from a very famous expert of strategy, that is Clausewitz. Clausewitz and his wife that was writing the book, that was von Kriege. Clausewitz was saying, the strategos need to know that in the high level of strategy, the complication, intellectual computation and big diversity of factor relationship occurs. What I mean, often today we say that today we live in a very modern, complex system, but it was true even 200 years ago. There was Clausewitz's description could be applied to the most sophisticated problem that we live today. And this is an example how we need the strategist to be able to deal with many factors. Obviously, at the time of of Clausewitz was no capability to do that with computers, with collecting many data. Was doing, in any case, using intelligence, using many capabilities. Today, strategic engineering can help to do that, combining simulation, data analytics, artificial intelligence to get the whole picture, a comprehensive picture, putting all together and provide evaluation of the consequence of the action. So we can evaluate many different course of action, evaluate corresponding risk, and support decision making going through. So let me say even what is our mission. Our mission is to develop this discipline, spread out in our community, working a lot with different institutions, agencies, as well the national institutions, universities, excellence center. We have agreement with some NATO center of excellence. We have agreement with national research center. We work a lot with companies, as I told you. Very challenging issue are in geopolitics, defense, etc. But obviously, probably major opportunity of development will be in industry, communication, energy, consultancy, defense industry, and so on, have a huge need of this capability. And so we feel that it's very important to prepare the young scientists to educate and improve the decision maker and senior officer, as well as to help company, institution, etc. to network on this subject. So let me say that we have many different roles for these engineers, because they can work using just tool and solution to amalgamate them, to design more often architecture that combine the three pillars together, to give direction and to talk with other scientists to develop the solution, to talk with the decision maker is very critical, because first of all, a big risk, and we identified this gap even talking in NATO and other organizations, the decision maker is too far away from the person that is in charge of analytics and let me say scientific approach. And this, the risk is that the scientists, the analysts develop an analysis solution that are good but are not useful for who decide, because they don't have such degree of freedom to take such decision. Maybe he can act on different subject, on different variables, so they need to talk each other. There is also another big gap. If we develop good solutions scientifically, architecture that works to support decision, but decision maker don't trust them, and obviously he have to deal with choice that involve his career, $1 million, or even human life, he cannot take such decision. So a role for the strategic engineers will be even to keep in touch strongly with decision maker, to be able to make them confident with the tool, knowing power, capabilities, limitations, and using them. So it's not just to construct tool, but is construct, using, let them evolve. And at the same time, it's very important to get the whole picture. This is one of the reasons we teach our strategic engineer not only on simulation, artificial intelligence, data analytics, and many other aspects, creating algorithms, but we teach even 4 classes in economics and 2 classes in international affairs to make them ready to understand the risk and characterize risk of an area, of a country, of a region, as well as to be able to talk with decision makers that often deal also with a lot of economical issues. So from this point of view, we have a different aspect that are interesting. First of all, the skill that we need to prepare, we say, there are scientific engineering skills, but even economics, risk analysis, international affairs. Use can be very wide. They could go from business, consultancy, but even intelligence, geopolitics, defense. And let me say that the role inside a company or an organization, an agency, or it could be very different. And we create not only classes, but even workshops that are open to everybody to learn specific methodology and cooperate in this subject. Let me say also that we have our program structured over 2 years, and these 2 years are based on 3 semesters of laboratories and classes, as you can see. And the last period is entirely inside the company. I said a company, but could be a lab, could be a research center international. I would like to outline that we have even workshop, I already mentioned, many workshop open to company attendees, open to senior officer, etc., that allow to experience advanced methodology, to get information from experts. We have someone that has been proposed by, for instance, organization such as Schlumberger, that is the major expert in exploration for oil and gas, in data mining. We have other one that address hybrid warfare, that explain how to deal and how to use modern simulation to support in hybrid warfare. So a wide spectrum of activity. I would like to outline even that between the first and second year, we organize summer stage. That's different from internship. Internship takes 6 months, and people have to develop a strategic engineering solution on a real problem inside the company, inside the lab, international lab, etc. Summer stages are very short, 3-6 weeks, but they are devoted to make our person expert of reality, to make what we say in Italy, getting dirty hands. For instance, we have an agreement with the Italian Navy that we are finalizing right now to put some of them on board of military vessel to carry out some campaign, etc. We have with some hospital that is managed by our colleague from medicine department in Genoa, some hospital in Africa where they can go to give support on that. We have contact with consulting companies such as Centaur to put them living side by side for a few weeks with the manager to realize what is the life of a top manager. We have other one with Hitachi and with other company to follow commissioning and startup project. Obviously, in 3-6 weeks, you don't do a strategic engineering project. You just get familiar with the environment. But it's very good opportunity to understand the complexity of reality, to realize what are the small problems. Because if you will have to develop sophisticated algorithm, sophisticated architecture, you need to understand even the complexity of reality. You needed to realize that you should be human, humble in front of this complexity, and to identify what are the real problems to be solved. And obviously, I take the example of the Navy, but you can apply from construction yard to an application installation of a new software solution without a company. If you spend 3 weeks on board of a military vessel, you don't become a SALT. You don't become an expert of sailing. The expert of sailing spend 20, 30 years at sea. But in such 3 weeks, you will be completely different respect somebody that never may carry out this experience. And this is what we want to achieve. And we look even for partnership to carry out other of these experience in different fields. This is an option, it's not mandatory, but some of the companies are very interested to use Thales, A4 Cyber, and many other ones. So I already mentioned that Strategos have a very good partnership, many companies, institutions, in different fields, business, international affairs, defense, etc., join major company, major corporation. We see 4 major different opportunities for job in this area. One is in big industry like Hitachi, Leonardo, Thales. One is in consultancy like Accenture, Greenpoint, Torino. Another one is in small, medium-sized enterprise that probably develop specific algorithm, tool, solution. And last but not least, is a major agency, national department, national institute to address the complex, field complex problem. We are very willing to enlarge this group. So if your organization is interested to participate, please join. You can find on the top the URL, that is www.itim.unij.it/strategos, but I will show you later even more precisely, and you will get all information to get in touch. We'll be very glad to have you on board to put you on the loop. Let me just mention something else that is about Genoa University. We are very proud from being from Genoa. Genoa, you know, university has around 40,000 students and dates back to over half a millennium. It was established in 1471, so we are pretty old, not the oldest, but among the oldest. And the engineering school was established in 1870, so over 150 years. So I would like to say that we are very proud of Genoa, but we don't see Strategos just as a local Genoa initiative. Strategos is one of the first Master of Science scientific in strategic engineering worldwide. We are here to create a strong partnership. We are here, we are glad to lead, but we feel that our long tradition is here, survived and lasted up to today because we worked on leading technology, on being on the front end of initiative, and we see this initiative, Strategos initiative, exactly in this sense. Let me even say you what are the opportunity. The opportunity for joining Strategos are many, because it's not only to be part of this very innovative approach that change the paradigm, use advanced technology, but even in a new way, to create a new capability, but it even give opportunity to put your employer, your officer, on the loop and to learn this new capability. It can allow you to select best student, best qualified people to be used in this framework, if you are looking for, to organize exercise, role-playing game experience, to train your staff to be part in this exercise, to learn how to deal with critical issues such as hybrid warfare, cyber warfare, strategic decision in many different sectors based on data, based on algorithm, based on artificial intelligence, and then to the use of simulation to forecast consequences of the action and correct them dynamically based on scenario evolution. And we will offer even position inside our steering committee in order to get contribution from you about subject to be investigated, topics, workshop, exercise, etc. to work all together. So here we have a synthesis in 10 points of what is Strategos, but I feel that you understand clearly that it's international, it's an international initiative, strongly transdisciplinary, strong core in engineering and science, but even economics and international affairs. We provide strong liaison with user, industry, consultancy, high-tech enterprise, international agency, national department, as well as a decision that is devoted to support decision maker, consider all the critical issues that now emerge about strategy and security, so dealing with combination of many factors. And we sure would like to have you in touch with us if you are interested in this subject, and to get your feedback and get your involvement, eventually your talents inside this loop. I would like to give you just a couple of examples of strategic engineering projects that could be used to understand in practical what it means. This is a case that we developed and we even demonstrated in NATO about hybrid warfare application. It's a public domain and has been created in order to investigate this kind of scenario where you would have to deal with very comprehensive scenario, very comprehensive environment that consider diplomacy, economics, media, strategic communication, stratcom, cyber aspect, cyber warfare, threat network, and so on. In this case, we analyze scenario that is in a region with a big town in a desertic area, four minor towns around, some village, some critical infrastructure. In fact, we have a critical infrastructure that deals with the port, with an oil terminal, we have a refinery with tank farm, we have a power plant, we have a desalination plants that guarantee fresh water to this urban area. We create a simulation reproducing population, reproducing threat networks, reproducing even the cyber layer with computer, fixed computer, mobile, etc. And we collect all the spillover information that came out from the threat network. That means if two persons that are in threat network that communicate, and we have an asset of capability to collect the spin of information, we report this one. It was initially developed to support CACS, but has been used even to support mission environment analysis, risk analysis, reduction of vulnerability. And then on many channels, from email to mobile communication, text, WhatsApp, etc. And you can even place traditional and innovative assets like autonomous system, web app, etc. in order to improve your capability to keep the situation under control. We adopted MS2G. MS2G is a paradigm for simulation that creates simulations that are very massive. This is an example of our model running inside a spider. Spider is one of our box, 2 meter by 2 meter by 2 meter and 6, where you can go inside multiple people, touch the scenario, interact with the world, changing the scenario, changing point of view, review what happened, changing paradigm, rerun the simulation. So it makes immersive, but even intuitive, interactive. And these models are interoperable, able to be connected with other systems, so you can experience the scenario. Now, I would like to outline one fact. In this scenario, it was possible to launch media attack, attack with autonomous systems such as a swarm of UAV against the refinery, or even a cyber attack to disable some kind of injection of special virus attacking the integrity of data or special server to compromise the server of the poor security and then attack with drone. Now this was demonstrated 4 years ago, 2015, in NATO, and 5 weeks ago, I mean in September 2019, exactly this kind of attack was carried out against the major refinery worldwide belonging to Aramco in Saudi Arabia. This demonstrates the very actuality of this approach, the potential to reduce vulnerability, and the importance to adopt this approach. Let me show you a completely different example. This example is about Janus. Janus is a serious game that we developed for Big Four consultancy company, and this is a simple game where the player, that normally is a trainee or is a junior consultant, they need to support consultancy inside a digitalization project in the company. You have to interview some manager, the director of marketing, the director of ECT department, the director of human resources, and the director of management control. And these people can belong to different culture, background, could be open, friendly, can be negative, aggressive, and they react even changing based on how the player plays. So if you fix a meeting, don't respect the timing, etc., is a problem, you needed to coordinate all these activities. Now, this was good to train people, but there is something more. We connect this one with artificial neural net. This artificial neural net was collecting information, and the question that you posed to the director that was played by intelligent agent with some avatar, with some bot behind, and analyzing the question, replies, etc., the artificial neural net identified if there was inconsistency. For instance, one manager give you some data, another one some other one, another one try to avoid the question, a point. So you identify if there is a critical issue in the digitalization project about this aspect, this sector, this service to be activated. Now, this was very good to create self-assessment capability to evaluate the trainee, because you can use that for training, but even to assess if they are skilled, if they are good, etc. But it's even more interesting because in the future, this kind of application can be on the laptop or the tablet of the junior consultant when he make interview and give directly feedback to understand if there is some problem in an interview with an attitude of some people, etc. Let me show the last example. Last example is about big exhibition. We have a simulation that combine many different aspects, and this aspect deal with a critical event that could happen in a mass exhibition. In this case, was this new huge building that involved over 10,000 people flows, and where you can put some kind of show. And in this case, what was interesting? We combined different aspects. These aspects include engineering, in terms of safety engineering, cyber security, cyber warfare, threats, terrorists, the possibility of truck that block security entrance, all together in the same framework. This is a very good example how to use strategic engineering even for big event. Any case, we'll be very glad if you will be interested in this subject and you can join, you will find information about the website. So let looks forward for opportunity of cooperation. Thank you.